नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर कोमल राठौर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कुमार भृत्य, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर राजस्थान. सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे सेशन वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट स्प्लीनोमिगैली. सो व्हाट इज स्प्लीनोमिगैली? लेट्स स्टार्ट. स्प्लीनोमिगैली, इट्स रेफर्स टू एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ स्प्लीन बियॉन्ड इट्स नॉर्मल साइज. So it's an enlargement of spleen. A spleen is said to be significantly large if it is palpable at least 1 centimeter below costal margin in a child more than 6 months of age. So significantly enlargement of 1 centimeter below of a spleen in a child more than 6 months of age. So in 30% of newborn and 15% of infant less than 6 months, palpable spleen is a normal variant. So splenomegaly different definitions by weight: mild, moderate and massive. So mild splenomegaly is count when spleen weighing 400 to 500 gram, moderate in spleen weighing 750 to 1000 gram and massive is more than 1000 gram to indicated massive splenomegaly. So function of spleen is reservoir for platelets, monocytes and FV third etc. and hematopoiesis in fetus and repair and destruction of RBC by culling and pitting. So what is culling and pitting? So pitting is removal of inclusion body, that's called Hens body and Howell Jolly body, without destroying RBC. And culling is removal of damaged and old RBC from circulation. So it is very important function of spleen. So it is very important what is pitting and culling. So culling is removal of damaged RBC, and pitting is removal of inclusion body without destroying RBC. So it is, remember, what is the function of spleen. Now grading of splenomegaly. So grading 1 is normal, not palpable, even in deep inspiration. Second is palpable, just below costal margin, usually on deep inspiration. And grade 3 is palpable below costal margin, but not projected beyond a horizontal line halfway between costal margin and umbilicus. The projection need to be a certain along a line drop vertically for the left nipple. So it is important grade 3, palpable below costal margin, not projected beyond a horizontal line. So costal margin and umbilicus. Now grade 4 is lowest palpable point approaching the umbilicus level, but not below a line draw horizontal through umbilicus. And grade 5 is lowest palpable point below umbilical level and not projected beyond the horizontal line, situated halfway between umbilicus and symphysis pubis. So it is important, again, grade 5. Grade 6 is lowest palpable point beyond lower limit of grade 5. So it is very hard splenomegaly. That is the grade 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. It is umbilicus and symphysis pubis. It's beyond, it's a grade 6. Now, perfusion of spleen. It is important. Perfusion of spleen is normal. Left mid axillary line, 9th and 11th intercostal space, width is 4 to 7 centimeter. So enlargement of splenic dullness is splenomegaly. Splenic dullness enlargement called splenomegaly. Now percussion. Percussion is from 3 method. Percussion of trap space boundary. It is important. Left anterior axillary line, 6th rib and costal margin. This area should be resonated on percussion. And dullness indicated possible splenic enlargement. So it is important, percussion three matter first in left anterior axillary line, then sixth rib and costal margin. So this area should be resonant on percussion. It is anterior axillary line and sixth space, that is called trabeospace, and area of percussion for Kestrel sign. This is costal margin. It is costal margin. It is anterior axillary line. Now percussion of Kestrel method. Percussion on the lowest left intercostal space. Lowest intercostal space. Anterior axillary line, usually 8th and 9th intercostal space. This space should remain resonant during full inspiration. Dullness on full inspiration indicated possible splenic enlargement. It is the positive Kestrel sign. Now method third, the hooking maneuver and middle lateral. So it's a place a patient left first under their left posterior chest position. Yourself on the patient's left side facing the patient feet, using both hand, curling your finger under the patient left costal margin. Ask the patient to take long deep breath, attempt to palpate the spleen with your fingertips. So it is important, hooking maneuver method, so keep mind. Next is sign and symptoms. So what is the symptoms? Symptoms of abdominal pain and tenderness or tiredness, early due to splenic encroachment, and symptom of anemia due to accompanying cytopenia, infectious febrile illness, pallor, dyspnea, bursuing, or patchy, like hemolytic process. So pallor, dyspnea, bursuing, and patchy. Now causes of splenomegaly is for infective, hyperplastic, congestive, and infiltration. So infective, hyperplastic, congestive, and infiltration causes for splenomegaly. Now splenomegaly in children is that metastatic neuroblastoma, infection, autoimmune disease like juvenile rheumatoid arthritis, hemolysis for hereditary spherocytosis, sickle cell anemia, and thalassemia. Next is neoplasia. It is acute lymphatic lipoma and Hodgkin disease, NHL, and acute and chronic myeloblastic leukemia and neuroblastoma. Inherited diseases, Gaucher disease, and other storage disorder. So it is important, splenomegaly in children, in which condition? So metastatic neuroblastoma causes splenomegaly, and infection is a more common form. So special situation associated with splenomegaly. It is also important point. So fever, like typhoid, malaria, Kala Azar, infection, endocarditis, leukemia, and lymphoma. Tender spleen is rupture, abscess, infarct, and illness plus anemia is AIHA, leukemia, fever plus LN like IMN, leukemia, lymphomas, SLE, and sarcoid. Anemia like hemolytic anemia and hemoglobinopathies, jaundice like cirrhosis, hemolytic anemia, and pulsatile spleen is aneurysm, high ESR. In some investigation, high ESR causes connective tissue disorder, leukopenia like Felty syndrome or septicemia. So it is important, splenomegaly. Now physical examinations, physical examination cause size of spleen, hepatomegaly, lymph adenopathy, fever, icterus, bursuing, patchy, oral and superficial sepsis. So it is important some physical examination like and stigmata of liver disease, stigmata of RA and SLE, and splinters, hemorrhages, retinal hemorrhages. So splinter hemorrhages and retinal hemorrhages is very important. Cardiac murmur is also important. So physical examination should be done for inspect spleen. Now lab investigation also important. If physical examinations do not determine what is the size and in which size spleen get enlarged, so lab investigation is must to be done. So first is CBC, blood smear, rectic count, blood CS, serology for fungal and viral parasitic, LFT, HB electrophoresis and Coombe test, coagulation profile, amylase or lipase test, AMA, NTCCP, RA factor, and bone marrow analysis. So thank you for all, and hope you like that session, and it is important and very beneficiary session. Many examination asking questions about spleen and splenomegaly. So if you have any query, if you unable to understand, and if you have any doubt, so you can ask me in further session. I will definitely resolve your problem. Try to resolve it. So that's all for now. Thank you for now. Thank you.